wanna be. Live my life like a vacation. Every night a movie.
You can be whatever you wanna be. You can do whatever you wanna do. All you gotta do is put the work in and sit back and watch your dreams come true. You can be whatever you wanna be. You can do whatever you wanna do. All you gotta do is put the work in and sit back and watch your dreams come true.
Dragonfly.
Think I can get the $80 you owe me now?
Silence! Silence! I ain't got no money, pal.
Look, I don't want any trouble. My life's about to get cut off.
Had you been practicing on your art, you know you're way in the dark. Silence! Silence!
Now hold on.
Somebody done told you wrong, punk. It's on.
So the first thing I saw when I pulled up to the charts, this was the afternoon New York session, so it was around like 2 to 3 p.m. First thing I saw was this intermediate swing low. I'm going to mark it up for you so you see it. I don't want my computer moving so slow.
A few moments later.
All right, so there's your intermediate swing low. You have highs and lows marked. If you pay attention right here, this liquidity got taken by this. So whenever that happens with this model, I'm looking basically for a reversal. So at this point, after that liquidity was taken, I'm waiting for a large move to the downside, grabbing this liquidity and breaking this intermediate term low. But I need a move with some momentum. I need like one of these type candles, one of these type candles, one of these type candles. Like I need a big move down, leaving me a fair value gap. And this is what happened. I said, okay, I saw this happen. It broke. It broke this intermediate term low. And once that happens, I'm waiting on a pullback. So as you see, price starts pulling back. And at this point, I'm just gonna drop a fib on it so I can make sure that my entry is going to be in a premium since I'm looking for sales. And the premium is going to be above this 50% mark on the fib. So I'm just waiting patiently. And I see this here. Order block. Bearish order block. And at that point, that's where I'm going to be looking for entry. Stop loss is probably going to be...
Mr. Huff, Mr. Jeaner is ready for your interview.
Actually, we'll be interviewing as a team. We're here to fuck shit up.
play a new sound. We gon' live on stage. Move it. Display a new sound. Check it out. You now rockin' with the fat sound.
I think my stop loss, I think I honestly just put it over the swing and took a quick scalp right here to this gap. And the gap I'm referring to is right here. So I'm gonna mark it up so y'all can see it. So that's a bullish fair value gap. And I wanted to take profit here. I could have held it to the liquidity below. But to be honest, this month, I haven't really been liking the way that the price action has been. Like you see here, it's like real choppy. And yeah, I just want to take a quick scalp and get out the market. Like I said, I could have held liquidity. I could have held to liquidity here or here. But I TP'd right here. And my stop loss was right over the top of the swing of the order block. Risk 19 pips to win 40. And this is what happened. It tapped me in right here. Trade activated. I'm in the trade at this point. Boom. TP smacked.
Which one of y'all kicked me?
It did pull back after that, so I was glad that I took a profit here. But even if you would have put your stop loss over the top here, over the top of the fib, over the top of the main swing, look what happens. Price pulls back and then drops right to this liquidity here. Right to this fair value gap. So you could have took profit at either one. If you would have had a tight stop loss, you would have had TP smacked right here. It would have came back and probably took you out of break even. Once you saw it rejecting again, not covering these highs, you could have entered again and taken the sell down here to liquidity. So yeah, this was a great trade for me. I came to the market afternoon session. I usually don't trade the afternoon session. I was just coming back from the gym and I had time to peek at the market, looked at it, and then yeah, it was just a perfect setup. All my confluences was there. I stuck to my rules. My stop loss was safe. And yeah, the rest was history. TP smack.
Jeez.
So yeah, I appreciate y'all checking out this video. This was how I made $1,500 trading NAS. Till the next one, I'm out. Peace.